Hello! Just finished watching Alive. Great film. True story about people that died and survived in a horrific plane accident. Now, the beers have been up and down so far. But this beer, sent to me by Kevin Black. I think it's the Real Ale of Britain. But when you Google it, type in Real Ale of Britain book. Basically, what it was, it was going to try this at a pub, and I said to him, I says, do a live review, do a beer review from the pub. And he did, which is pretty cool. And then it just said, he enjoyed it so much, he gave it a 10 out of 10. So, but that was on Cask. This is the bottle. Baby Baffler. Now, where's it gone? What's with that? Because when he did his review, he did it, I think he was in a dimple glass, not mine. So, look, I'll look for a bit because, wow. Because I like taking my pictures of the beers I'm drinking. And if I pour it all in, I'll end up drinking it all. Wow, there's a burn. Yes, probably more. It's a real ale. Camera says it's a real ale, so must be a real ale. It arrived on Thursday, but because I went to a camera beer festival, I've saved it till today, which is Saturday. There's a slight spice in there as well. Bit of licorice. Bit of dry on the smell. Just look at the lacing on the glass. And it looks like it does have a bit of coffee in there. And maybe a little mocha. The body is... You can see through it, but I don't know if that's the glare of the glass. But mostly chocolate. Wow. Definitely chocolate. Getting lots of burnt chocolate. Not much on there, Bob. It's very rich. Let's look. This Imperial Stout has an abundance of chocolate and, well, and also coffee flavours. I don't get much of the coffee. I mean, I put it in the lace and the glass. It's super dark. It's got like a warming sensation in the chest. Inspired by our brewer's Italian family. Eating, so no, not like the people in Alive. I ain't eating humans, I've eaten pizza and nuggets. This silky smooth, rich stout, generous, apply of powerful, a perfect dessert beer. Now, it does remind me of the Great Divide Yeti, which is, I think it's 9.5%. It's like slight coal smell. Very sticky aftertaste. Very tasty. The ABV, you can get it. Because it's mostly the sweetness in it. But it's not too much. I know when I first started drinking IABV beers, it was like super intense, but I don't know if I'm past come accustomed to them now. Because I've drunk one of ones that does remind me of this one, the Goose Island Bourbon County Brand Stout. Now, that being said, Keeping Black give it 10 out of 10. I don't think I could be that generous if I was to rate a beer. Because the problem with rating beers is it's your first experience. And then you have it again, and it's like, oh, it's good, but it's not as good as the one I first had it. It's because your palate's changed. I think the other thing that this beer is missing is probably ice cream. Mean, when I had the Great Divide and also the Brooklyn Chocolate Stout, they were great over ice cream, as was. It is super tasty. This little tartness as well, and aftertaste. Well, you had it on cask. Coming back, could I drink this on cask? Probably not. It'd be too much sickly. And sometimes beers like this are perfect for home because you can just sit and relax. It's really tasty beer, to be fair. And all the beers that I've had tonight is the highlight. But it is super sickly. I would like to try this on ice cream and probably food pairing. It's really sweet. It'd probably be dessert beer. So yeah, just ice cream. Probably no. Yeah, just ice cream. It's probably too sweet. Yeah. The only other thing, I was gonna say beef, but you might try it out. So it enhances the sweetness. It is a super tasty beer. I'm glad I've left it to last because it wrecked my palate. But yeah, it's a nightcap beer. It's not one you would volunteer on cask because it's just too sweet. Ice cream, definitely pair with this. You take care. Goodbye. Oh, and thank you, Kevin Black. Good luck with the book.